On this week's stack, we're going to be diving into Alyssa Holland, who may be nerdier than me when it comes to productivity tools. She's a senior software engineer and has a huge love for these tools. She also runs a podcast with her sister called Culture In Between, exploring the childhood and background of individuals with parents from different cultures. I had such a great chat with Alyssa, and we're going to be diving into the apps, routines, and productivity rituals that she uses to get things done. My first question for you, Alyssa, is how did you get into coding and front-end development in the first place? What was the story behind all of that?
Yeah, so I'm Alyssa. Let's see, I have been a software developer for the past 10 years. I specialize primarily on the front-end development, so building out user interfaces, what you see when you interact with a website. I kind of got into it by accident. I was actually a musician, played saxophone all throughout middle and high school, but I didn't want to be a starving artist or the music education teacher. So I was like, okay, what do I do? My dad was like, Alyssa, you have a knack for computers, which at the time just meant I can make the printer work because my parents are not the most technology literate people. But ignorance was bliss in this case because I ended up majoring in computer science. And had I known how hard it was going to be, I might not have done it, but I did it. And now I've been in the field for a while and really, really love it.
So Alyssa, my next question is around your routine and how you plan your day out, especially with productivity rituals in mind, because I know you're a bit of a geek when it comes to that, a bit like myself.
So a typical day at work is I usually start off and I go review my Slack because my company uses Slack and then we have, you know, myriad of channels there. So I just go and check and just make sure I haven't missed anything. You know, nothing's on fire, whatever. Thankfully, my days are pretty light on meetings. We have a stand-up, which is what like developer teams do. It's like twice a week is our cadence, but if meet for like 15, 20 minutes, and we just go through our Jira board. So Jira is what a lot of our companies use. For some reason, every company I've worked at has used Jira for the most part. I would love to use Linear, actually, personally, but I don't have enough of a like project need for a dedicated tool for that. But at work we use Jira, so we go, our manager will go through the Jira board and we kind of get aligned on what everyone's working on. I meet with our internal designer once a week just to do a design sync. Because I do front-end development, I meet with her regularly just to make sure we're on the same page and I'm helping building out our design system. And so we use Figma as our main design tool for that. So she would kind of show me if there's some new designs, she'll show it to me on Figma. And then we kind of go through and iterate and stuff like that. Let's see. And then outside of kind of those meetings, I'm pretty heads down. A lot of my work right now is building components for a component library, kind of polishing up the user interface, or just planning upcoming tickets. And then sometimes go to the gym about 2-3 times a week and go hit the local trails. And that's kind of a typical day for me.
So Alyssa's background and story is really interesting. And if you really like these sort of tool stack breakdowns and conversations, then you can check out toolfinder.co/stacks. We got loads in there, over 75 that you can go into and explore. You can also check out more videos below if you're interested. And if you are enjoying this video, please do give it a thumbs up as well.
Yeah, it feels so infiltrated into my workflow now. And it's so weird because I feel like it's like November 2022 is when we kind of first heard about ChatGPT. And I remember I was like petrified because I was like, oh no, I'm going to be irrelevant. And like watching, I think GitHub Copilot do some things and then seeing ChatGPT. And I was like, oh my goodness. And I actually wrote a blog post on this one time, like just my thoughts on generative AI in general and stuff like that. Because instead of being scared of it, I was like, okay, well, let me take the bull by the horns and see kind of what it is. And I actually had a task I was working on at the time. It was building out some type of charts and I didn't quite know how to do it with the libraries and it helped me. It wasn't great, but at least got me in the direction of what I needed to go. And from that point, I was kind of like, oh, okay, I see it as a tool in my tool belt right now. And as a developer, I think you kind of have to integrate it. So many companies now too are like paying for us to use it in our code editors, which is nice. And so how I use it now as a developer, I use it for mainly brainstorming and refactoring code. So a lot of times I'm working on something, it works, but it's kind of ugly. Like the code is not super it's kind of messy. So I'll sometimes bring in ChatGPT at that time and just be like, hey, how can I refactor this? use some more elegant programming patterns, things like that. Or if I'm just trying to like, okay, I'm stuck on this little part, how would you suggest I do it? That's kind of how I like to do it, because I still love writing code. I don't really ever want the AI to do it for me. But if it can help me do some of the boring stuff, like we have to write test cases a lot of times, those aren't the most fun. And those kind of follow a typical flow. So I kind of have AI do a lot of that stuff. And I've actually been experimenting now with speech-to-text tools, like Super Whisper is the one I've been using. I did a trial for like 2 weeks, and then I ended up getting the lifetime plan because Neil, who's kind of the creator of it, is pretty public about how he builds it and stuff, and it's very customizable. And so that's been something I've been using now. So now I just kind of talked to it, and then it kind of helps me brainstorm even more.
So finally, for the fun bits where we get to dive into the app side of stuff, Alicia, could you share a little bit about the apps that you use every single day?
Yeah. So I kind of have some categories. So I'll talk about my editor and dev environment. So the most popular editor right now is probably VS Code. I also use, we use PHP at my job, but WebStorm, any JetBrains is the company, those products. So I kind of bounce between those two editors depending on the project or what kind of focus mode I'm in. For version control, I use something called Fork, which is like a Git GUI client. In code, like you're like comparing, okay, what changed versus what was there before. And so that's just kind of a helpful way to manage that. I don't use it all the time, but it's just kind of helpful way to view my changes. For a terminal, which is basically like the low code way, or the developer way of kind of navigating between things and running commands and all that. I don't know how many people know things. I'm just going to try and explain it. But like my terminal of choice is Warp. Yeah, is Warp actually. And then because they've really, the terminal is something that's been around for like forever, like decades upon decades. And so, but it hasn't, it's really gotten a lot of love lately, the past 5 years or so, which has been really cool. And so Warp is kind of this company that's been enjoying, they have like kind of a more modern take on it and little productivity boosts like AI commands and suggestions. Like, unlike in like text editors or something, you can actually use your cursor in like a terminal. Like you have to kind of like use shortcuts to get back, and so they make it so that like you can actually use your cursor to like type in. So it just, yeah, it's just kind of a nicer way. They predict kind of where you want to go based on things. So that's kind of my dev tool setup, I would say. On like the task and productivity side of things, I use Sensama. I've been a user of them for the past 2, maybe 3 years. It integrates well with Jira. So my tickets are, you know, outlined in Jira, and then I can just, you know, import them in. And then what I do is I go in and then add subtasks and annotate things, because you can have stuff that's only visible to you. So a lot of times I break down like, okay, well, how am I going to do it? And I just have my little notes just within there. I've also been experimenting with like Ellie Planner recently. I love Sensama. It's a great tool. I just don't know if I utilize all the like mindfulness stuff as much as others. So I've just kind of been dabbling a little bit, but I know this is the way. And so, but Sensama for now, and I like that you can like time box, or you can, you know, time yourself and stuff. And for scheduling, I just use like the built-in Apple calendar, actually. It works for me. I don't need anything special. For let's see, for blog and writing and stuff, I have a like Notion is what I use. I'm a very, very simple Notion user. Like I do some basic database stuff and some different views, but like nothing complex like relational databases and or whatever. Like some people get nuts in there, and I'm very simple with Notion. So I have a blog board that is just like a Kanban board view. And I just have like, anytime I have an idea for a blog post, I dump it in there. I put like resources and things. And then I use Hashnode is where my blog is hosted, and they have like a AI powered markdown WYSIWYG editor kind of thing. So I just kind of, I will actually draft my letters in there, and Hashnode's editor is actually free. They have a free version now there. And then I'm actually pretty analog or like I like to write things down a lot too. So I actually use a Remarkable 2 to just jot down notes and things. And so I love to do that. I love the e-ink tablets. I actually have a Kindle Scribe too, because you know, you need 2 e-ink tablets. So I use my Kindle Scribe for like my work notes and stuff, and for reading, of course. And then Remarkable 2 is kind of for more personal stuff. I don't know why I need 2, but that's what I have. I guess the last set is like, there's some honorable mentions. I guess Raycast is really good for just, you know, zipping to opening up apps and just clipboard manager, just a whole bunch, a slew of things. Shotter, S-H-O-T-T-R, and CleanShot X are like what I use for, I do a lot of like, hey, like when I'm showing off something I'm building out, and so I need to take a lot of screenshots and just a quick thing. So that's what I use. And then CleanShot X is if I need to like do a video and send like a demo of something. So those are kind of my main tools, I think.
So it's really great to see a sort of balance of offline and online productivity there. That balance of Sensama and Remarkable and other such tools is really great to see. But also from a software engineer perspective as well. We get to cover a lot of different individuals on this channel, but we get a lot of founders, a lot of others that are sort of working on businesses, but never sort of the development side of stuff. So it's so great to see that. So a big thanks to Alyssa for coming on today. And if you did enjoy today's stack or you want to explore loads more of them, you can check out Stacks over on Toolfinder. We're planning to do more of these, so do subscribe if you're new, and I'm looking forward to bringing you some more. So I'll see you very soon in the next one. And thanks again for coming along and watching Alyssa's stack.